The information in the following video applies to Home Designer Pro. In Home Designer Pro, you have the ability to draw custom ceiling planes to customize the ceiling for your model. In this video, I will show you how to use the Custom Ceiling Plane tool to create a vaulted ceiling along with making a tray ceiling. To start, the flat ceiling needs to be removed from the room. Custom ceilings won't display if the automatically generated flat ceiling platform is in use in the room. To do this, I'll select my room and open it for specification. On the structure panel, I will uncheck flat ceiling over this room. This will remove the flat ceiling platform over the room and will allow any custom ceiling planes I've drawn to display. I'm going to build a vaulted ceiling that is at a different pitch than my roof planes. My roof planes are currently at an 8 and 12 pitch, and I want my ceiling planes to be at a 4 and 12 pitch. Ceiling planes get their starting pitch from the default roof pitch. In order to draw my ceiling planes at the correct pitch, I can either change my default roof pitch before I draw the ceiling planes in, or change the pitch after the ceiling planes are drawn in. For this first example, I'll change my default roof pitch. Be aware that changing the default roof pitch while you have auto rebuild roofs turned on will cause your roofs to rebuild at the new pitch. It's recommended you have your roof completely built first before changing your default pitch and drawing your custom ceiling planes in. Changing the default roof pitch is done through the Build Roofs dialog. To access the Build Roof dialog, I'll go to my Roof Tools Parent button and then click on Build Roof. In the window that comes up, I'll first uncheck Auto Rebuild Roofs. This will make it so Home Designer stops rebuilding my roof every time I make a change to my plan. Now that I've unchecked Auto Rebuild Roofs, I can change the default pitch and my existing roof planes won't change. I'll change the default pitch to 4 and 12 and click OK. Custom ceiling planes are drawn in a very similar way to roof planes. I'll first select my Custom Ceiling Planes tool under the Roof Tools Parent button. I'll move my mouse over the outside edge of my wall until I see the red snap indicator. Once I see that, I'll click and drag to draw the baseline or the edge where my ceiling plane is going to rest on the wall. Once I've drawn the baseline, I'll release my mouse and move it in the upslope direction. Once I've established the upslope direction, I'll click to place the ceiling plane in my plan. I'll repeat this process on the opposite wall. Again, I'll move my mouse until I see the snap indicator, then click and drag to draw the baseline of my ceiling plane. Then I'll release the mouse and move it in an upslope direction, and then click to place my ceiling plane. To join my ceiling planes together, I'll use the same tool I use for joining roof planes, the Join Roof Planes tool. To do this, I'm going to click on my ceiling plane on the edge I want to join together to the other ceiling plane. It is very important to select the proper edge of the ceiling plane. Selecting the wrong edge of the ceiling plane will cause Home Designer to not join them together properly. The way I can make sure I have the proper edge selected is by looking for the edit handle on the edge that is a different color. This edit handle is the selected edge edit handle. When an edge is a selected edge, that means it is the edge Home Designer will be modifying when choosing an option from the Edit toolbar. In this case, when I click the Join Roof Planes tool, the selected edge is the edge Home Designer will be trying to join to the other ceiling plane. Now that I have my proper edge selected, I will simply click on the Join Roof Planes tool in the Edit toolbar and then click on the edge I want to join together. Home Designer will then take care of the geometry and perfectly join the ceiling planes together. With the ceiling planes joined together, I'll drag the other edges of the ceiling planes to the gable walls to cover the entire room. A thing to note about drawing custom ceiling planes. Unlike roof planes, ceiling planes only draw to the outside edges of the walls they're resting on. In this example, the ceiling plane baselines are drawn over the walls they're resting on, but the sloping edge should butt to the inside edge of the wall. Drawing them to the inside edge of the wall will make sure the wall framing extends all the way up to support the roof instead of getting cut off by the ceiling planes. For this next ceiling design, I'm going to turn off the roof planes layer in my plan display. This will make it so I won't accidentally select a roof plane when I'm trying to modify a ceiling plane. To do this, I'll first make sure my plan view is the active view by clicking on the title bar for that view. With the plan view active, I'll go to the Tools menu and click on the Display Options option. I'll then scroll down to the R's and find the layer called Roof Planes. I'll remove the check mark from the display column and click OK. Now that I have the roof planes turned off, I can grab each of the ceiling planes and adjust them without having to worry about accidentally grabbing the roof planes. I'll select each ceiling plane and set their interior edge to be 3 feet in from the outside edge of the wall using temporary dimensions. I'll then hold down the Shift key and click on each ceiling plane to group select them. I'll then open them both for specification. On the general panel, there are several options of values that can be locked. Which value you set to be locked is the value that won't change when you make changes to the other values. Think of it as setting the pivot point for the ceiling plane as it changes pitch. In this case, I want to keep the inside bottom height locked to 109 and an eighth. This value is referring to the height of the ceiling plane at the top of the inside edge of my framing layer. By locking this value, when I change the pitch value to 0 instead of 4 and press the Tab key on my keyboard, the inside bottom height value will stay the same and the other values will adjust having a pitch of 0. Once I've changed those values, I'll go ahead and click OK. Now, I'm going to draw in two new ceiling planes at the default pitch of 4 and 12. I'll do this by selecting my ceiling plane tool and snapping my mouse to the edge of one of the ceiling planes already drawn in my plan. Once I see the snap indicator, I'll click and drag to draw the baseline of the ceiling plane, release my mouse, and move in the upslope direction, and click to place the ceiling plane. I'll then repeat this process on the other side of the room. I'll then select the inside edge of my ceiling plane, click on the Join Roof Planes button, and click on the edge of the opposite ceiling plane to join them together. I'll then drag the edges of the ceiling planes out to complete the ceiling. Using tools like the Custom Ceiling Plane tool, you can create several different kinds of custom ceiling shapes to meet your needs.